Okay, dear student, in my next video of this chapter, that is exponent or indices part 2. So, in this chapter, in this part, I will express you how to solve various problems and a little bit more rules that I had already explained to you. Let us discuss. Since we had already discussed about various laws of your exponent, that is product law, quotient law, power law, etc. So the rules, that is a to the power m into a to the power n will be your a to the power n. Okay, another rule we have stated, a to the power m divided by a to the power n, that is your a to the power m by n. Third rule we have expressed, that a to the power m and then whole to the power m can be expressed as a to the power m into n. So these are the power law. Okay, fourth law we had already explained, that if your square root of x is there, that can be written as in the power form x to the power 1/2, that is the fractional power. This is your square root. Similarly, if your cube root of x is there, it can be written as x to the power 1/3. Okay, and if there is nth root and here x to the power m, so in that case we can write it in the power exponential form m by n. Okay, these are the rules. Again the remaining rules, you see, if your a to the power minus n, that is the negative exponential, then you have to first convert it into positive exponential, that is reciprocal of 1 by a to the power m. Then if suppose there is a fraction, base is fraction and power is negative, then to convert positive power, what we will do, we will just reciprocal b by a to the power m, then it will become positive. Okay, and again we have also explained the zero exponential, that means x to the power 0 is your 1. Then another rules here, suppose in this case if a b whole to the power m, in that case this will be your a to the power m into b to the power m. Okay, you can split up into 2 or more. Then if you will say divide a by b whole to the power m, this can be written as a to the power m divided by b to the power m. So these are the various rules of your exponent which we will see. These will help you to express your results while solving the various numerical problems. Okay, now you have got it. Should I remove? So altogether there are 10 rules. Let us do some numerical problems related to this exercise. Suppose you have to simplify. Suppose your question number 1 is simplify. Your question is, say, 9 to the power 3 by 2. 9 to the power 3 by 2. And then minus 3 into 5 to the power 0. And after that, minus 1 by 81 to the power minus 1 by 2. So this is your problem. Now we have to solve it. So here 9 can be written as 3 to the power 2. 9 can be written as 3 to the power 2. And then in the outside the power is 3 to the power 2. Okay, 3 by 2. So 9 can be written as 3 square, and then power in the 9 is your 3 by 2, that we have written. So minus 3 into, as you know, 5 to the power 0 is your 1, anything to the power 0 is 1. Minus, since the power is negative, to convert it positive power, you simply invert it by finding the reciprocal, that is 81 by 1 1 by 2. Now power become positive. So what will happen now? You can multiply the power together. So this is your 3 into 1 is 3. Now this 81 can be written as 9 to the power 2, and then in the outside it is power 1 by 2. So here 2 to cancel, this will be your 3 to the power 3 minus 3, and this will be again 9 to the power 2 into 1 by 2. So 2 to cancel. Your final answer will be your, this is 3 to the power 3 means 3 into 3 into 3, that is 27, then minus 3, then this will be again minus 9. So what will happen? This will be your 27 minus 12, that means this will be your 15, will be the answer. Okay, you have got it. In this way, you can solve it. Now, second question. Question number 2. Suppose there is a question like x to the power a minus b, then whole to the power is a or a plus b into, and then x to the power b minus c, x to the power, that is b minus c, whole to the power b plus c into x to the power, that is your c minus a, x to the power c minus a, and whole to the power c plus a. So you have to simplify this. This is your question. What you will get the answer, you see. Here you just multiply. You apply the power law. You apply the power law. This will be your x to the power a minus b into a plus b into x to the power b minus c into b plus c into x to the power c minus a into c plus a. Okay, so this will get x to the power a square minus b square. In class 7 you might have studied the factor a plus b, when multiplied with a minus b, your answer will be a square minus b square. Then again into x to the power b square minus c square, because here b minus c into b plus c will be b square minus c square. Then again into x to the power c square minus a square. So ultimately what will be your final result? All have the same base. So this will be your x to the power a square minus b square plus b square minus c square plus c square minus a square. Since the base are same, then power must be added. While adding all these power, what will happen? This b square plus b square minus b square cancel, plus c square minus c square cancel, minus c square minus plus c square cancel. So this will be your x to the power 0, and the answer will be again onto your 1. Okay, this is also one type of question. So you have got it. Now should I remove? Okay, third question. Third question, maybe suppose find the value of x. Your question is find x if, that means condition is given and you have to find your x. Say your question is square root of p by q equals, square root of p by q equals your q by p to the power q by p to the power 1 minus 2x, 1 minus 2x. So in this question, after solving, you have to find your x. Okay, first you write given square root of p by q equal q minus q by p to the power 1 minus 2x. Okay, this is your given part. Now you see, since base is your p by q, you have to change the base. That means you have to find out the reciprocal. So for that, what you will do? You take this minus of this power that I had right now explained. So while expressing this p by q can be expressed as to the power 1 by 2 because square root of p by q is your 1 by 2. When you change the reciprocal of this base, so you can write p and q. So that means the power become minus of 1 minus 2x. Okay. So when you reciprocal the base, the power become negative. That right now we had seen. So what will happen then? So this will be your, now you write by comparing. By comparing both sides. So here p by q base, here p by q base. That means then if in order to maintain the equality, power must be equal. So that means 1 by 2 must be equal minus 1 minus 2x. Okay. Now you have to solve this equation to get the answer. So this is your, you just cross multiply it. Okay. In the left hand side it is 1, in the right hand side it is minus 2, 1 minus 2x, you open the bracket, so this is your minus 2 plus 4x, minus 2 plus 4x and in the left side it is 1. So now you take 2 in this side, that is your 1 plus 2 and then 4x will be in the right side. What will happen next? You see, after solving, this is your 3 and here it is 4x. So, x will be your 3 by 4. This is the answer. So, in this way, you can solve this type of problem to find the values. Okay? You have got it? Now, we can say another type of simplification. One more simplification we can do. Okay? So next question, for more simplification, we can say, the question is, suppose we are having 2 to the power, say this is your 2 to the power 10 plus a, 2 to the power 10 plus a into 4 to the power, 3a minus 5. 3a minus 5, this is the part in the numerator and in the denominator 2 to the power 4a plus 1, 2 to the power 4a plus 1 into is your 2 to the power 3a minus 1, 2 to the power 3a minus 1. So now what we'll do, all the base are up to, so you change this. So in that case what will happen? Here both, in the numerator there is a symbol of multiplication, in the denominator also the symbol of multiplication. So the simple way is your 2 to the power 10 plus a, 10 plus a into, instead of 4, you convert it as your 2 to the power 2 and then in the outside it, the power is your 3a minus 5. In the denominator, it is 2 to the power 4a plus 1 into 3 to the power 3a minus 1. Okay. So now what we'll do here, this is your 10. Here you can add the power 2 to the power, this is your 10 plus a. And when 2 is multiplied with the outside power, then it will be plus 6a minus 10, that this much will be in the numerator. In the denominator it is 2 to the power 4a plus 1 and 2 to the power 4a plus 1 and this is your 2 to the power 3a minus 1, 2 to the power 3a minus 1. Here also base are same, so again your power will be added plus 3a minus 1. Okay, now after simplification, this 10a, this 10 and 10 cancel each other, here minus 1 and plus 1 cancel each other. Now in the numerator 6a plus 1a is 7a and in the denominator 2 to the power 4a plus 3a is again 7a. Now you can write 2 to the power 7a minus 7a means 2 to the power 0 means 1. Okay, so in this way you can also simplify the results. Okay, you have got it very well. So this much is over for today. Okay, see you next day.